Welcome to bilingual e-lectures for diploma students in fluid mechanics and fluid power. We are discussing about the flow of fluids, second unit in fluid mechanics and fluid power. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about the discharge, about the continuity equation and energies of a flowing liquid. So, what is discharge? Discharge, that is also called rate of flow. Discharge is defined as the quantity of liquid flow across a section in unit time, that is the rate of flow per unit time. The volume of flowing liquid per unit time through a section of a pipe, this is also defined as the volume of a liquid flowing per meter, flowing per unit time through a section of a pipe. It is also known as rate of flow. It is denoted by Q and its unit is meter cube per second, SI unit. See, consider this figure, this is a pipe. In this, this is the area of flow, area of a section through which the water is coming out with the velocity V. Then let us consider the area of the pipe, V velocity of flow and Q rate of discharge or discharge. So, discharge is equal to volume of cylinder per unit time, that is equal to area, volume is area into velocity, that is equal to meter square into meters per second, that is equal to meter cube per second. So, discharge is equal to area into velocity, that is equal to volume of liquid, that is equal to meter cube per second. The unit is meter cube because area is meter square and velocity is meters per second, then meter cube per second. So, it is the quantity of liquid flow across a section in unit time, that is area into velocity, A into V. Then next is, we are going to see the equation of continuity. What is equation of continuity? This equation states when an incompressible fluid is flowing continuously through a pipeline, the flow rate or the mass flow rate of a liquid is same at all sections. That means, the discharge is same throughout the section. If you considered a pipe, a taper pipe, in that a steady incompressible fluid is flowing continuously. This is the conditions. Incompressible fluid means it is a condition, then continuous flow is a condition. Through a pipeline, the flow rate, that means the discharge, is same at all sections. So, for that, with reference to this figure, consider a taper pipe in which liquid is flowing continuously. So, taper pipes means at section 1-1, the area is A1 and the velocity at this point, one point is V1. Similarly, at section 2-2, the area is A2 and the velocity is V2. Similarly, the area is A3 and the velocity is V3 in section 3-3. From the figure, we see that area 1, A1 is bigger than 2, A2 and A3. A3 is very small with compared to A1, right? But while flowing, the flow itself is adjusted. If area increases, then velocity automatically reduces. That velocity increases when area reduces. It is self-adjusted during the flow and the total rate of flow, that is Q1 at 1-1, Q2 at 2-2, Q3 at 3-3 remains constant. This is called equation of continuity. So, once again I will repeat, this equation states that when an incompressible fluid is flowing continuously. This is a condition, incompressible fluid, steady fluid, incompressible fluid, continuous flow agudhu abdingiradhunala. So, it is a condition when an incompressible fluid is flowing continuously through a pipeline, the flow rate, the mass flow rate or discharge is same at all cross sections, whether it is 1-1 or 2-2 or 3-3, the discharge is same. This is called continuity equation or equation of continuity. So, let us see A 1 area of pipe at section 1-1, whatever, then V 2, V 3, A 1, A 2, A 3. So, the total quantity of liquid passing through section 1-1, Q 1 is equal to A 1 into V 1. Similar, because discharge Q is equal to A into V. So, at section 1-1, this is Q 1. The area is A 1, velocity is V 1. So, the unit is same, meter cube per second. Similarly, Q 2 is equal to A 2 into V 2 at that point, at that section. Similarly, Q 3 is equal to A 3 into V 3. So, according to this continuity equation or equation of continuity, the discharges at all sections are equal, the discharges are equal. This is the most important, that is this Q 1 is equal to Q 2, that is equal to Q 3, that is equal to discharge. Hence, Q 1 is A 1 V 1, A 2 V 2, A 3 V 3. So, discharge is equal to A 1 V 1 or equal to A 2 V 2 or equal to A 3 V 3. So, this is the continuity equation. At all sections, the discharge is same. This is also called continuity equation. We will see some problems. A taper pipe from 75 mm diameter to 45 mm diameter, the quantity of water flowing through the pipe is 0.15 meter cube per second. Find the velocities at the two sections. See, you see the figure, you refer this figure, section 1, a pipe tapers from, this is diameter 1, diameter 1 is 75 mm to 45 mm D 2. The quantity of water flowing, that is Q, quantity of water flowing means volume of water Q, that is equal to 0.15 meter cube per seconds. What is the velocity V 1 here and V 2 here? This is the question, right? We know D 1, consider D 1 the bigger area, that is the inlet velocity is equal to this diameter is equal to 75 millimeter. So, we want it convert to meter. So, 75 by 1000 is equal to 0.075. meters. Usually, the pipe is of circular cross section. So, circular cross section pipe means if this is the diameter, then area is equal to pi by 4 into d square. So, we have d is 0.075 square, then area 1 at 1 is equal to pi by 4 into 0.075 square is equal to 4.41 into 10 power minus 3 meter square. Similarly, D 2 is equal to 45 millimeter, that is equal to 0.045 meters. Then A 2 is area at is a cross section 2 is equal to pi by 4 into 0.045 square, that is equal to 1.59 into 10 power minus 3 meter square. Then discharge already given is 0.015 meter cube per second. Find the inlet velocity and outlet velocity V 1 and V 2. We know that continuity equation that Q is equal to Q 1 equal to Q 2 equal to Q 3. Similarly, Q is equal to A 1 V 1. We can say A 1 V 1 is equal to Q. Similarly, A 2 V 2 equal to Q or Q equal to Q 1 equal to Q 2 or A 1 V 1 is equal to A 2 V 2, everything is same. So, according to this continuity equation, Q is equal to A 1 V 1, then V 1 we want to find. So, V 1 is equal to Q by A 1, that is equal to 33.359 meters per second. Similarly, V 2 is equal to Q is equal to A 2 V 2, then V 2 is equal to Q by A 2, though that is equal to 0.15 divided by 1.59 into 10 power minus 3, that gives the value of 94.31. So, here this is 33 point something, this is 94 point something. See, we already discussed while flowing, even irrespective of area and velocity, when area reduces, velocity increases and self adjusted, so that the discharge is equal. In area increases, velocity reduces. From this answer we will see. So, velocity 1 is equal to 33, so diameter is 75 mm, may be 0.075, it is bigger size. So, here the velocity is more, V 2 is 94 something and A 2 is 0.045. So, here the area is less, velocity is more. Area diameter is more, velocity is less. So, the continuity equation proves that the discharge at any point in a pipeline, if the fluid is flowing continuously, incompressible fluid, then the rate of discharge, that means the discharge is constant. Okay. So, V 1 is equal to 33.9 meters per second, that we have to see. Because Q is equal to meter cube per second, area is meter square, then meter cube, 3 and 2 cancel, then meters per second. Next problem, determine the diameter of the pipeline which carries 100 liters per minute of water with a velocity of 0.25 meters per second. So, they are simply asking what is the diameter of the pipeline that carries means that moves, that discharges 100 liters per minute of water, velocity is 0.25 meters per second, right. So, they are given data, velocity 0.25 meters per second, discharge is equal to 100 liters per minute. So, 100 liters per minute, we have to convert it into meter cube per second. So, for liters to 1 meter cube is equal to 1000 liters. So, conversion is divided by 1000, that comes 100 by 1000 comes, what comes, meter cube per minute, then we want to convert it minutes into seconds. So, 60, so 1000 into 60, that is 100 divided by 1000 into 60 gives meter cube per second, that is 1.667 into 10 power minus 3 meter cube per second, that is equal to 100 liters per minute. And find the diameter D, the unit is meters. So, according to continuity equation, Q is equal to A into V, then area is equal to Q by V, that is equal to 1.667 into 10 power minus 3 by 25, that is equal to 6.666 into 10 power minus 3 meter square. So, this is equal to area, and we know area is equal to pi by 4 d square, then d is equal to, d square is equal to 4 a into pi, that is equal, d is equal to root of 4 into a divided by pi, that 6.6668 into 10 power minus 3, that is area into 4 divided by pi, we will get 0.092 meters, that is equal to 92 millimeters. This is the answer. Next problem, a 0.3 meter diameter pipe carrying water branches into two pipes of diameter 0.2 meters and 1.5 meter and 0.15 meter. Please refer the figure. If the mean velocity of 0.3 meter pipe is 2.5 meters per second, and that in the 0.2 meter pipe is 2 meters per second. Determine the discharges in the pipes and the velocity in the 0.15 pipe. So, diameter 1 D 1 we considered, this is the direction of flow, D 1 is equal to 0.3 meter. Then A 1 we calculated using this formula, pi by 4 into D 1 square, that is equal to 0.0706 meter square. D 2 we considered this 0.2 meter diameter as D 2, then A 2 is 0.0314 meter square. Then D 3 this pipe, this is equal to 0.15 meters. Then A 3 is equal to 0.0177, then V 1 is equal to 2.5 meters per second and V 2 is equal to, this is 2, this is 1, this is 3 and V 2 is equal to 2 meters per second. We have to find Q 1, Q 2, Q 3 and V 3. So, Q 1 we know that A 1 V 1, that is equal to 0.1765, direct substitution. Q 2 is equal to A 2 V 2, then we get, then V 1 Q 1 is equal to these two, A Q 2 plus Q 3, because the water is flowing this direction. This discharge is equal to this discharge and this discharge, Q 2, Q 3, this Q 1 is equal to Q 2 plus Q 3. So, Q 3 is equal to how much? Q 3 is equal to Q 1 minus Q 2, that is equal to 0.1137 meter cube per second. Then we know Q 3 is equal to A 3 into V 3. So, V 3 is equal to Q 3 by A 3. Q 3 we know, then A 3 is 0.0177, you will get V 3 is equal to 6.42 meters per second. So, this is about continuity equation. So, continuity equation states that the discharge at any section, that is Q, is equal to constant. Then Q is equal to A area into velocity and its unit is meter cube per second, where A is equal to meter square and velocity is meters per second. So, this is continuity equation. Then energies of a fluid. What is energies of a fluid? Energy is the ability to do the work, capable to do the work. So, it is available in different forms in fluids, it is available in different forms. The energy possessed by a flowing liquid consists of energies due to its position, pressure and velocity. So, they are classified as three energies. One is potential energy, that is also called static energy or datum energy, whatever. It is because of virtue of its position. So, it is called a potential energy and another one is pressure energy. So, pressure energy, or sometimes we call it as flow energy, that is virtue of its pressure, the work done by the particle. Then third energy is kinetic energy. So, kinetic energy is also called velocity energy. So, these three energies are possessed by a flowing liquid. what is potential energy or potential head, we can call it as potential head also. The energy is by virtue of the position of the liquid. If the potential energy or water irukku or liquid irukku and the water ipo neenga verum ground level la irundhadnal adoda potential energy is different, zero. Idhe idu vandu oru 10 maadikku mela irukku, oru 100 feet ku mela irukna the potential energy is because of that position, endha edathila irukku abingiradha poruthu dhaan. If it is the energy possessed by a mass of a liquid by virtue of its position in space. So, consider a liquid mass m occupies a position z above the datum line, then potential energy is equal to mass into acceleration due to gravity into z. Z is the potential energy position z. That is equal to, we know that mass into acceleration due to gravity is equal to W weight. So, that is equal to potential energy is equal to W into Z. Then potential energy per unit weight of liquid per unit weight, that is equal to this potential energy divided by W. So, W cancels, then Z. This is called, Z is called potential energy or potential head or datum head or static head, edhu venalum sollalam. So, Z abdingiradhu, it is the potential energy per unit of liquid, per unit weight of liquid abdin sollalam. Idha vandhu nama datum energy nu sollalam or datum head abdin sollalam, static head abdin sollalam, illa potential head abdin sollalam. Adutathu pressure energy or pressure head. So, it is the energy possessed by a liquid particle by virtue of the existing pressure, by virtue of its existing pressure. Consider a fluid under pressure P with load W, with some load, moves through the distance h. When the weight is moved or lifted, or weight irukka thookudhu appadina, the work is said to be done by edunala pannudhu, by the liquid pressure. Then, so weight is equal to force due to the pressure. So, we know pressure is equal to load by area, P by A. So, above weight is equal to pressure into area, right. Then, the work done by the pressure, work done means the distance moved into weight, that is equal to W into H. So, H is the distance moved, then weight is equal to load or force is equal to P into A. So, P into A, pressure into area. So, work done by the pressure is equal to W into H, that is equal to P into A into H. So, P into A is equal to W. Then, we consider this A into H, A into H, we consider this as volume. So, pressure into volume of liquid. So, we know from the specific weight, specific weight is equal to weight per unit volume W by B, V, then V is equal to W by small w, right, weight per specific weight. So, the pressure energy per unit weight of liquid is equal to P into volume, that is volume is W by small w, that is equal to P into V, that is equal to this V, we substitute W by W, P into W by W. So, this equation is divided by G, acceleration due to gravity, then and rearrange this equation P by W. So, P by W into W by G. So, we know that W by G, we take it as W is equal to mg, then W by G is equal to m. So, we put this w by g and replaces with m. So, m into p by w, m is mass, pressure and specific weight. So, pressure head per kg or per mass of liquid is equal to, so here m into, that is equal to m into p by w divided by m. So, m and m cancels, we get p by w. So, this is the pressure head. The pressure head or pressure energy is p by w, where p is equal to intensity of pressure and w is the specific weight. Then kinetic energy. So, kinetic energy, we call it as velocity energy or kinetic head. It is the energy possessed by a moving liquid particle by virtue of its motion or velocity. The energy possessed by a moving liquid particle by virtue of its motion or velocity is called kinetic energy. If a liquid particle of mass m moves with mean velocity v, then kinetic energy is equal to half m v square. So, we know m is equal to w by g, that is w is equal to m into g, then m is equal to w by g. From this equation we derived this. So, we substitute w by g in place of m, then that equals to that equation half m v square is converted to half into w by g into v square. So, we rearrange and write that w v square by 2 g. Kinetic energy per unit weight of liquid, that is equal to again divided by 1 by w, then w w cancels, then we get v square by 2 g. So, v square by 2 g, this term is called kinetic energy or kinetic head or velocity head. So, total energy, what is the total energy of a flowing particle? So, total energy of a flowing particle is the sum of potential energy, pressure energy and kinetic energy, or total head is equal to datum head plus pressure head plus kinetic head. So, total head is potential head is z, then pressure head is p by w, then velocity head is v square by 2 g. So, the total head of a flowing liquid is z plus p by w plus v square by 2 g meters of liquid. Next is Bernoulli's theorem. So, what is Bernoulli's theorem? Bernoulli's theorem states that for any mass of steadily flowing condition, steadily flowing incompressible liquid, another condition in which there is a continuous connection between all particles, that means continuous flow. So, in this session we discussed about the discharge rate of flow, that is q is equal to a into v meters cube per second, and equation of continuity, that is the discharge of fluid is same at all sections in a pipeline if the flow is continuous. Adhaan vandu continuity equation appdin solrom, and the continuity equations nama clarify nalla clarity venum abdingarakaga we did some problems also. Then what are all the energies available in a liquid, that also we discussed, that is datum energy or potential energy, pressure energy and kinetic energy. So, the total energy or total head is equal to the sum of potential energy, pressure energy and kinetic energy. The total head is equal to potential head, pressure head and kinetic heads, that is a sum, that is z plus p by w plus v square by 2 g meters. Thank you.